To orbit in Rhino, you right click and drag on the mouse. To zoom, you use the scroll, you spin the scroll, and it zooms where the cursor is. To pan, you hold down shift and you right click. And all of those could work in any of the four viewports. To bring, let's say, a basic object such as a box, you could go solid box, corner to corner. And now it tells you here what is the first corner, so you could click anywhere. Then he wants to know the length, so you drag it, click again, and then he wants to know the height. Click again. So we can right-click, zoom, shift right-click to pan. And if we want, we can click here and go into shaded. So we can see our object shaded. If you need to delete an object, you select it. If it's yellow, it means it's selected. And you press delete on the keyboard, not backspace. Unless you do FN backspace, I think that might work. Another way of getting a box is to click here. It's the exact same thing. And now I'll do it a different way. The first corner, I could type 0, enter, so it starts from me. And here we can tell we're in millimeters. So I could type what is the length. Length is 60 millimeter. What is the width? 10. The height, 4. So now we actually have enter proper dimension. If you want to switch dimension, type units, enter. And you could switch them here to inches or something else. Now, another way of doing the box is to type. You don't have to click here, you just type. And that's, I think, is the easiest way. If you know the command, you just type box, enter. Then you can type 0, and you could just freely drag it. So now we have a box. If you need to visually see the dimension, so let's redo it, box again, or you can go right click or enter, that would repeat the last comment. So if I go right click, the last thing I did was box, I'm back into the box. And then I draw the box. If I want to see my dimension, I can also go dim, like dimension dim. And I make sure that my O snap should usually always be on with N near, midpoint, and intersection. Quad, it's not super important, but it's usually what I have on. And then I track twice and I can see the dimension. Here it's not, I can right click to redo it. They have decimal because I freehand draw that box. To maximize, minimize a view, you double click on it, like I'm doing. So now if I properly, I'm just pressing delete, redraw a box. I could go box, center 0, length 80, width 15, height 8. Now I can go dim, enter, make sure OSnap is on. So it's snapping, it's sticking to the object. And we could, so you could, if you need to print this on paper or give this to someone else. For the height, I would do it in this view. Here. Voila. If I need the box to have fillet, like rounded edges, what I can do, there's a command called fillet, but because here it's a solid, solid means it's filled in, it's not hollow. When you click on an object, if it's one big entity, usually it's a solid. So edge is always for solid. So if it's a solid, a 3D object filled in, you would go fillet edge. This is the radius of my fillet. So one means 1 mil here. So it's pretty small here. So I click here and I'll try maybe 4 mil. Enter. and then I can just pick what I want. Enter to go to the next question, and it shows me a radius. Enter again. And now we can see our object. I could also go in render, so if I don't want to see the line, and then go back to shade. So using this technique, we can actually build a very simple ring. Most of the time, I start my rings in the front view, so I'll start it here. And this time we're going to use a command called Torus. Torus is like a donut or a ring. Center of the torus, 0, enter. I want to make sure I'm in diameter, not in radius. So make sure here it's a diameter. And I'll press 17 mil. I'll hold shift to be straight. Shift means orthographic, vertical or horizontal. And then enter. So I have the first one, and this is the second radius, and here I'll just eyeball it. So it looks like a ring, something like this. Now we can see our ring. If you're far away, you can also go Ctrl-Shift-E, and that will do a zoom extent. So once again, Ctrl-Shift-E. Now in this view, I'll add maybe some sphere. So I'll type sphere, center 0, hold shift to be straight, and then I can move my sphere up. So this is called a gumball, that little manipulator. As long as this is turned on, you should see it. And you can move this up, zoom in. If you need to make a copy, you press Alt. You hold Alt on the keyboard and drag, make a copy. To scale in all axes, you hold Shift and you click on one of the square. And then we can move. This is also to rotate, if you want to rotate. And on those things, you can also type, you click and type, you can say plus 2 mil, Control Z to undo, or you could say 90 degrees. Here it's a sphere, so you won't see much, but you can also do things like this. Or if you want to scale, you can click here and say 0.8, that would be 20% shorter. You could do things like this with the combo. So I make sure that they pretty much go halfway through the ring, like this. I'll make another copy, so I can go mirror, MI, start of the mirror plane, 0, enter. And here I can hold shift to be vertical, and I've got a mirror. Maybe we can add one more stone. So Alt to make a copy. Shift to scale uniformly. And then you can drag them. Here sometimes it's O snapping, it's sticking. If you want to temporarily disable O snap, you press Alt. So Alt, disable O snap. Voilà. And we can mirror that one again. MI, 0. Then I want to combine those objects together. So because they are touching, I can use a Boolean. One thing I wanted to change quickly. I think they are not close enough. They're a bit too far away. So, and you see I'm snapping again, so I'm pressing Alt to bring them a bit closer. Oops, I made a copy. So I can mirror that one again. MI, 0, shift. Yeah, they could still be closer up. Boolean union, that's to glue them, to merge them all. So I select them all and I go enter. And now you see they've been glued together, they've been cut. If I click, it's one big piece. So now they are one solid. So then I can do fillet edge. 4 might be a bit too big, so I'll try maybe 0.3 just to see how big it is. And I'll select one. And we can see it's already pretty big. So here I could actually select all of them. In real life, those ones should maybe be smaller than those ones, but enter, enter. Yeah, this, you don't really want overlapping fillet like this. It could work, but so I think here what I should do, it's redo fillet edge, 0.3 for the big sphere. Enter, enter, that's all right. I right click to redo fillet, 0.2 for the medium one. So you could select also, you just like this. I'm just left clicking. And maybe 0.1 for the baby one. Wow. Now what I want to do is have the inside of the ring sharp, flat. So I can use a command called cylinder, C-Y-L in the front view, 0 for the center. And then I'll press Alt so I'm not O-snapping, and I'll stop somewhere. And then I switch view and I do the depth. Then using the gumball, just the green arrow, I want it to go through. And then I can go Boolean difference. So difference will make a hole. So subtract from whose will receive the cut, the ring, enter. Subtract with who is cutting the cylinder. Well, and I think it's a bit thin. So what I would do, I'll undo. And in this view, I'll select the cylinder with this one and I'll make it a bit smaller. So I go shift and I'll scale down just a hair with Alt so it doesn't snap. Here the best would have been to zoom in a little bit. So shift and then press up. Yeah, that should be better. So Boolean difference, subtract from this one, enter with this one. The last thing we can do here is do a fillet edge, very small one, 0.1 or even less, maybe 0.08. Oh, 0.08. And then I can select this. Enter, enter. Voila, so if we go and render, we could actually send this to Shapeways in 3D print. And it is two size, it's 17 mil. So if you want to do something like this, you could go export selected and save it as a STL, this one. And most 3D printer or SLC would print this. Voila, hope you enjoyed it.